Today's video is on solving and graphing inequalities. It's going to be focused on multiplication and division inequalities. So we need to be aware of both the multiplication property of inequality and the division property of inequality, because they're going to be the key to showing how that makes sense. The process we follow for solving inequalities is very similar to that we use for equations, in that whatever you do to one side of the inequality is the same as the other side of the inequality. So just to demonstrate this process, you're going to compare the equation 3m equals 15 and the inequality 3m is less than or equal to 15. As you know, the three steps we follow to solve equations is we isolate our variable by doing the inverse operation. Since this equation shows being multiplied by 3, we're going to divide 3m by 3, leaving us with the variable alone, isolated. Because of the property of equality, whatever we do on one side of the equation, we're also going to do the other. So 15 divided by 3 equals 5, and that tells us that m does indeed equal 5. If I plug that in, 3 times 5 does equal 15, and we know that equation is true. Now, within inequality, we follow a very similar three steps. We're going to isolate our variable by doing the inverse operation, dividing by 3, leaving us with m, and then we're going to use the property of inequality. And the property of inequality states that if I divide this side by 3 and I divide this side by 3, the two sides will remain true. Not equal, but true. Right now they're saying this is less than this. It will still be that way. So if I divide this by 3, I'll divide this by 3, I'll still get 5, but instead of bringing down an equal sign, I'll bring down a less than or equal to sign. Now this tells me that m is less than or equal to 5, but it doesn't tell me what m equals. So what I'm going to do instead is I'm going to graph my data with a number line, showing me that m could equal 5, because it could be equal 5, or it could be anything less than 5. So I'm going to think of numbers that I know could make this true, for example 4 or 3 or 2, and I'm going to draw an arrow pointing to the left, because that's going to show me every answer to the left of 5 or 5 would be solutions to this inequality. That's called our solution set. So here I've got both a multiplication and a division inequality, and I'm going to solve each of them using the property of inequality. So here I'm going to isolate my variable x by dividing 7x by 7. That leaves me with just x. Because I divided this side of the inequality by 7, I'm going to divide this side by 7 because of the property of inequality, leaving me with an answer of 9. I bring down my symbol, and it tells me x is less than or equal to 9. If I create a number line with a 9 on here, I know that 9 could be a value that would make this inequality true. I can think of many smaller numbers like 8 or 6 or 2, and so I'm going to draw my arrow pointing to the left because it's now pointing to all the values that are in the solution set. It doesn't point to the right because any number larger than 9 would not be part of the solution set. In this division inequality, I'm going to do the inverse operation, which means I'm going to multiply 3 times b divided by 3, and that cancels out and leaves me with just the b. Because I've multiplied this side by 3, I'm now going to multiply this side by 3, because the property of inequality states that if I multiply both sides by a positive value, that the two sides will remain true. All right, and so 6 times 3 is 18. That tells me that b must be greater than 18. So when I make my number line here, I'm not going to make a shaded circle. I'm going to make an unshaded circle because 18 would not make this inequality true. It needs to be a number greater than 18. So I'm going to point an arrow to the right because 20 would be true, 25 would be true, 5,000 would be true. Any of those numbers to the right of 18 would make this a true inequality. Final example I'm going to use is actually a word problem. And it says the soccer team must sell at least 300 candy bars to raise enough money to play in the tournament. Write and solve an inequality to show how many candy bars each of the 12 players must sell. Now, I've got to think for a minute. I don't know how many candy bars each player must sell. So that's going to be 12 times the number of, we'll say, C. And it doesn't need to equal $300 or 300 candy bars. It needs to be at least 300 candy bars. So I'm going to think to myself, at least would recognize that it could be 300 or it could be more than 300. So this needs to be greater than or equal to 300. So that's my inequality. Now to solve it, I'm going to isolate my variable by dividing this side by 12, leave me with just C, and dividing this side by 12. Now, 300 divided by 12 might be a term you don't know, so off to the side, you would actually divide 300 divided by 12. There we have it. Each player must sell greater than or equal to 25 candy bars. So if each player sells more than or equal to 25, then they will reach their goal so they can play in that tournament. That's all I have for today. Thank you.